What's going on, everybody? If you're like most people, you find the Ableton Warp Modes a little bit confusing, and I don't blame you. Like, when do you use one over the other? Complex? ComplexPro? What's really the difference? Let's go talk about it. Alright guys, today we're talking about warp modes, specifically complex versus complex pro. So first, I'm going to give you guys like the manual definition, and then I'm going to give you an English version of that so you'll understand it and you'll be able to use it. So first off, what is complex mode? Well, the manual says, complex mode is a warping method specifically designed to accommodate a composed signal that combines the characteristics covered by all other warp modes. It works well for warping entire songs. Okay, well, what's complex? Complex Pro Mode. Complex Pro Mode uses a variation of the algorithm found in Complex Mode and may offer even better results, along with an increase of CPU usage. Like Complex Mode, Complex Pro works especially well with polyphonic textures or whole songs. So what's the difference between Complex and Complex Pro? When would you use one over the other? Well, first, let's compare the two visually before we even jump into any audio examples. You notice that you get an envelope and formance slider with Complex Pro. So what are these guys doing? The envelope slider influences the spectral characteristics of the material. The default setting at 128 should work well for most audio. For very high pitch samples, you may have a better result at lower envelope values. Likewise, low pitch material sounds better with higher values. Then there's that formance ladder. The formance ladder adjusts the extent to which the formance of the sample are compensated when transposing. At 100%, the original formance will be preserved, which allows for a large change in transposition while maintaining the original tonality. Note this ladder has no effect if the sample is played back untransposed, which makes sense. Well, it's no wonder this could be confusing. That doesn't actually tell you very much, especially if you're new to this. So let me put this another way for you guys to understand. Complex offers you pitching you want to hear, and Complex Pro offers you pitching that you do not want to hear. Let me show you some examples of what I mean by this. But before we jump into it, let me encourage you to subscribe and hit the little bell, where you'll get notified every time I have a new video come up. As an Ableton certified trainer, I talk about everything from sound design to pro tips to plugins you need to have. Plus, I make bass music under the name Scarlet, so stay connected. So if you have an a cappella or a vocal, it's a really good way to show you this example, and maybe you're doing a remix and you want to pitch these vocals up 3 semitones. Now, if you do this in complex mode, you're going to get this chipmunking effect. Let's hear what this sounds like. So here's the original audio. I'm never gonna dance again. Here's the audio pitched up 3 semitones in complex mode. And here it is in complex pro mode, and then I'll let you hear them back and forth. I'm never gonna dance again. I'm never gonna dance again. I'm never gonna dance again. In complex pro, notice that it is still transposed, but it sounds a lot less like a chipmunk and a lot more like the original audio. Well, Jerry, why wouldn't I just want to use Complex Pro all the time? That seems like it's doing the job and sounds better. Yeah, but you're forgetting about pitching that you do want to hear. Like, for example, a pitch bend effect. I've got this already edited. Let me go ahead and consolidate it so we can actually apply the pitching. I wanted to wait so you could see this. Now, I'm going to switch it to Complex Mode, and you'll notice that we are getting this chipmunky, rubbery sound, but we want that. Dance again, dance again. So, the two different ways that you could use Complex, Complex Pro. Complex mode, pitching that you want to hear. Complex Pro mode, pitching that you don't want to hear. I mean, you want it to be pitched, but you want it to be as transparent as possible. Now, a little pro tip for you guys is that if you take these two sliders in Complex Pro mode and turn them all the way down, what you actually have is Complex mode. Let's check that out. I'm never gonna dance again. 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 So now you know that there's this gray area in between, and you can kind of dial in exactly what you want if you want something in between the two. Finally, the CPU tip. When using Complex and Complex Pro modes, the manual says that the CPU is 10 times more intense than any other warp mode. So, you might want to go ahead and freeze and flatten or consolidate your tracks when using Complex and Complex Pro modes. All right, guys, that about wraps it up for warp modes. I hope you found that interesting. Until next time, I'll see you.